Talk about them good birds for a little bit.
I'm flipping a bird, a bird is a word. I'm flipping that bird, that police and nerds. I think outside the back.
Won a series against Toronto. We whooping up on Tampa right now.
We probably got the MVP. Got to read a home run.
And we got the MVP.
God damn, I ain't put my bet in yet.
Them all is probably crazy now. And we still got the best catcher in the league. We got a rising star at third base. All while our rotation is in shambles. Bullpen has been better. Bullpen has been better as of late, but we don't have too many healthy arms in the starting lineup. But
I mean, they've been pitching well lately, though. I mean, yeah. we definitely criticize them when
absolutely.
We get on when they bad, and they've been better. Deserve, but you know, the pitching staff has been better, a lot better, especially that damn bullpen. Mind you, you know they blew the game. Against Toronto, right? Was it Toronto? They blew one of them games. Yeah, blew one of them games in Toronto. But other than that, I mean, we was looking at the telecast yesterday. You know, that they got a sub 0.65. It's like 0.65 over the last 13, 14 appearances. They pitching well. That's all you can really ask for is, you know, once you turning over the game, a 3-2 game, a 4-3 game, a 1-2 run game, you know, that's all you ask for is them to come in and get out. It sucks that I gave Dylan Tate the confident, you know, the badge of confidence, and then ever since then he sucks. He's been ass ever since then.
You know how that goes. You got reverse.
Exactly. So hopefully he'll be better. You know, but how I'd be pitching him every day too. Give him a break. But other than that, like I said, I think I said a couple weeks ago the Orioles got score. You know, the bats are starting to heat up. The bats are doing what they got to do. So you come off the sweep from St. Louis, and now you win in 13 of your next 17. That's a crazy stretch. Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
that's a wild stretch. And if you win today, it'd be 14-18. And also you win today, that'd be 6 out of 7 against the Rays over the last 2 weeks, over the last week and a half. So, you know, you pretty much ended their season. So they playing well. You just got to keep on. You saying that the Yankees was real hot. You stayed attached to them. So, I mean, how I look at it is, you know, once they got over that, the bullpen issues and the St. Louis series, they playing like the best team in baseball right now. You know, besides the Yankees and maybe the Phillies, you know, they playing really, really well. Just gotta keep it together. We just gotta keep beating bad teams. And like I said, we talked about the schedule. You know, they playing it right. They playing doing what they got to do. So far, so I'm looking forward to the pitching. What points up? Grayson, I just need him to finish them out. And you know, he pitched well, taking a no hitter. You just gotta be able to finish those, man. Like you can't. I don't like giving up a hit to allow a run, and then you slam your glove, you get frustrated. Like you just gotta get your mind right. Get back on the mound. It's still another out to get, so you can get out this game and you can preserve this win for yourself, not for yourself, but only, you know, for the team. So I just like the frustration that he shows sometimes, too emotional on the mound sometimes. But other than that, I don't got too much bad things to say about him right now. Mullins finally got a hit. Hayes is the nitty curse. He playing well, hitting the ball over the damn park. They bringing up the young boys. So it's like, you know, it's a lot going right for Orioles right now. They just got to keep it up. They just got to keep beating bad teams. You play the Rays, you play the Blue Jays, teams you should be dominating. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. We talked about how we've dominated the AL East recently, and that has continued. It's always good, no matter what is going on with our team and just the injuries and so on and so forth, how, you know, once we get into AL East division baseball, we kind of lock in. And we start playing better as a whole. And that's been a consistent theme over this last year and a half, 2 years, as far as handling our business within the division. And that's going to help a lot just with, you know, success, right? We see them the most often. We're the most familiar with these teams, and we're using that to our advantage. So shout out to this team there. Corbin Burns, 8 consecutive quality starts, looking for his 9th today. It's already been given a lead in the first inning, so look to see him give a 6-7 strong and see what we can do there. I mean, he's been a godsend, especially with all the injuries, having that anchor, and then Grayson and Bradish. That top three has been really helpful, and it is going to be, if they can stay healthy, it's going to be very advantageous for us, you know, trying to win these series. You know, just having those rocks up there, as you know, the bottom half of the rotation is questionable right now. We have Suarez, who's been pitching decently, but you don't know what you're going to get out of him long term. Cade Povich, he has a lively arm. We've brought him up countless times on the show before, but now it's the big leagues. Right. And I'm sure there's going to be an adjustment period. He got a little roughed up his first start, but he gave us some innings and he struck some guys out. So some positives there. But the back half of that rotation, we're going to have to see what they're made of. And they've been thrust into bigger roles. So we'll have to see how they handle that. But, you know, it's going to be interesting to see what their metal is, because if they have it and if they are up to the challenge, it just makes it stronger organizationally when people do start to get healthy. So we'll see. Dean Kremer, he's going to be going on a rehab stint soon, hopefully. So he's on the mend. So hopefully, you know, we can get out of June with no further issues and start to get healthier versus the alternative.
Yeah. Speaking to Cade Povich, I think he'll be fine. But the thing is that happens with strikeout pitchers, especially. I mean, he was getting him and Chase McDermott might run into the same thing. They fan so many per game. You're talking about guys that are used to getting 8, 9, 10 strikeouts a game, just dominating. That adjustment is definitely real, and you can't come to the show thinking that that's how you're going to pitch. You're going to get into trouble. And you saw that against Toronto. He started overpitching. Everything was sailing on him, and the pitch that he did put in the strike zone, Vlad sent that shit to the six.
I say, once they saw him the second time, it was up.
Yeah, like
it looked good that first time through. But.
Yeah. That second time was like, oh nah, this the breaking ball ain't breaking like it's supposed to, and your fastball it got popped. But yo, I'm a major league player. I'm gonna figure this shit out. And yeah, they definitely sent it to Vancouver. He'll be fine. He'll be fine. He just got to learn how to pitch. He just got to learn how to pitch and don't throw, and he'll be fine. But, I mean, I still want a move to be made. I mean, you add somebody like Lizardo to the back end of that rotation as your fourth starter. I mean, you're going into the playoffs looking great. You're going into the playoffs looking great. If you got Corbin, Bradish, Grayson, and Lizardo, oh, come on. That's a World Series winning rotation right
and there. mainly to your point, I don't want to have to have as good as Cole has been for us. I don't need him starting playoff games. He can come in relief, like
long relief.
Yeah, like if needed be, but he can come in maybe that 6 and 7, but I don't need him starting no playoff games.
Nope.
You are going to need a dependable long guy, being that we have a young rotation. So Bradish, the Graysons of the world, are more comfortable in Bradish, but we don't know how they may fare in a playoff setting. As far as this would be only their second run, and the first run wasn't. It's not like it was a run; it was a light jog. But if that, it was kind of like a wheelchair ride at the nursing home.
up, get back here. All start.
But I mean, 2.5 games out of first place right now. Approaching the deadline within the next month or so, it's going to be interesting to see how aggressive the Yankees are. Because if they are aggressive, you know, and the Yankees typically are, we're going to have to keep up pace somehow. And you mentioned Lizardo, perfect example of how an acquisition like that could help with the task of either catching up to the Yankees or just being formidable against a team like the Yankees come playoff time. Last year, we won the division and it meant nothing. This year, maybe we have a different path. Whatever the case, you're going to see these teams in the playoffs, and none of that shit is going to matter in those postseason games. Division winner, wild card, none of that's going to matter. It's about who's going to be the more talented team and who uses their talents to win games. We could definitely use another punch out artist, that's for sure. But yeah, you know, we have enough now to be competitive, so we'll see.
Yeah, Urias is playing better too. Let's throw him in the tree. Let's throw him in the tree.
Mateo, everybody's hitting now.
Throw him in the tree while he's playing.
Hopefully it just rub off on everybody. You know, I like what I seen from Connor Orby too. I like what I saw from him.
Yes.
You know, He's like a miniature Westberg. Like, he just as well. Like, that's what I saw from him. Like,
do we see him as a super utility going forward, like long term? Do we see him like maybe we use this chance to kind of shop him? Like, hey, do you like what you see? This could be on your squad and try to get the pitcher. My thing is, by playing them, you open up all these possibilities. So whatever you choose, you can be selective with it.
Yeah, because we still got Kobe Mayo. So losing a guy like that to I mean, look, it worked with Joey Ortiz, and he was playing well, and look what we got out of that. So it can only help. It can only help, and we won't be at a loss for infield talent. We got plenty more down the pipe. So if the more home runs you hit, buddy, the least amount of errors you make in the field will only help you and us, because you want to play, I'm sure. And with Kobe Mayo probably being primarily a third baseman, it's looking like Westberg will be our everyday second baseman once that call is made and the infield is set. It's no way you to be, Connor. So you got to look at this as an audition for the whole league. As the whole league. So,
yeah. You want to know something interesting that has nothing to do with anything right now that I was weirdly looking into? I was playing the game, playing the show, running our franchise, and I noticed that Mike Elias, all the studs he's drafted have been drafted from the state of Texas. Like, if you actually, like, really? Look at all the guys, Colton Cowser, Westberg, Grayson, mm-hmm. you go down the line, everybody other than Gunner, you know what I mean? Everybody's a Texas kid. I thought that was the most amazing shit. Like,
Gunner's from where? At Mississippi,
Alabama.
Alabama, yeah.
Everybody but Gunner
from the Pacific Northwest, but other
Jackson people. Is from Texas. Like it was getting. I was like, "Yo, this dude got a. Is this the science?"
Well, hey, being in Houston for so long, he probably knew them guys already.
Yo, they it's a factory down in Texas apparently. Because if you go down his recent picks, it's a good amount of them from Texas, and all the top guys are from Texas. I was very surprised, but it makes sense.
Not a bad place to draft when it comes to baseball, I'll tell you that. Mm-mm. It's not a bad place. Speaking of things that are random, and this is super random, but baseball related, your Slim Thug son is like a college level pitcher in high school.
His dad is pretty big. Like,
no, he's taller than Slim Thug. He's like 6'8", 6'9". Yeah, and he got a gun on him. He got an arm on him. It was crazy. Wait, I don't even know how that popped up on my damn algorithm. I was like, yo, Slim Thug son?
That Slim Thug son with a gun on him.
Missiles. I don't know if you was watching the telecast or whatever, but they was comparing John Westberg or whatever. They just say he's a bigger, stronger, faster Dustin Pedroia. And I feel like I was right on. That was perfect. That was perfect. He's gonna be better than Dustin. If his career turned out Dustin Pedroia, that's a pretty damn good career. Like, you feel me? He got way more power than Dustin too. Like, way more power.
He's faster.
I like
better than Dustin. I like that though. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Just a contact hitter.
Yeah, like
I like that.
What he does to get a hit is really like, whoa. I didn't see that his rookie year, but he's a really good. Just contact hitter, putting his hands in the barrel out and just willing to just put the ball where defenders aren't. He's really good at that. And it's crazy because we started this year saying, yo, he's going to be the super utility guy. And look, hell no. He's an everyday
player. Not him.
Hell no. He's an everyday player, which is great. Great surprise that I'll take all the time. We don't need a position player, do we?
I think we're good there. We can't even fit the guys that we should be trying to fit in. We're definitely good there, but we could, because we have a gluttonous amount. It's time to reinforce the pitching, I guess. Because we got corner outfielders we could call up if we needed to. We got infielders. Got catcher. We even got there's nothing that we really need.
Sam Well is hitting home runs every damn day. And where is he at? Double A?
Mm-hmm.
I think he's Double A. He's hitting home runs every damn day. It's a lot. It is definitely a lot. And it's a good thing to have when you have needs to have the things that to go get them. Because a lot of teams don't even have the farm. It's like, yo, we cash considerations. And we got anything anybody else could need to boost their farm and to just get a rental, even if it's a rental. Go get the ring.
Yeah.
Do you want somebody long term? Absolutely. But I mean, If we get a ring this year and don't sign Corbin,
if we get a ring this year, Big Rube might wild out with the wilder. Because he seems like the type, he'll be turned up by like the parade, mm-hmm. and the celebration.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. He'd be ready to speak. We gotta get him open. I mean, you know what I mean. You know what I mean. You know what?
Yeah, we got you.
Yeah, absolutely. Oh man. Before